Okay, so before we get started with the video, I want you to subscribe to this channel and kindly turn on the notification bell so that anytime we drop any video, you'll be among the first to be notified about this video. And for those of you that have subscribed already, a big shout out to you guys. I love you all. Please subscribe to this channel. It's going to help us. This video is just a skill. It is a lucrative skill. You can learn it and you can make a lot of money with it. So I want you to like all the videos and subscribe. Okay, let's get into the main business.
Alright, so this is Magdi Graphic Studio. So I'm going to be teaching you guys Photoshop. We are going to be learning smudge painting with Photoshop. So we are, as you can see, I'm using Photoshop CS6. You can see it here. I'm using Photoshop CS6. Let's launch into our Photoshop. You can see this is my Photoshop. So I'm going to be importing an image. We are going to be using, I'm going to import an image we'll be using for this tutorial. I'm going to import a particular image, and that image will be as our reference picture. We are going to be using it to learn all we are going to learn in this Photoshop. So I want to pick an image. I want to pick an image that can suit what we are doing. Okay, I think this one is okay. You can drag and paste it in your Photoshop. Just drag the image and bring it inside your Photoshop. Or you can go to your file, go to open, and go to your file, go to open, then look for the image. Look for the image in any folder, you can find it and press open. You can open it by this way, or you drag the image. You can see the way I did it. Just drag it from your folder, and bring it to Photoshop. It will open. I seen it. So that's how I did it. So now I'm going to be teaching you guys the basics. So this is going to be an introduction class. I'm going to be explaining the little screen features. I'm not going to go deep in this Photoshop. We are just learning smudge painting. We are only learning smudge painting. So I'm going to be teaching you guys, I'm going to be showing you the tools we'll be needing. The tools we are going to be needing for this smudge painting. So number one tool here, we have the smudge tool. That's the main tool. The smudge tool, you can see it here. If you place your cursor on it, you will see the name smudge tool. And the second one we are going to be using is the pen tool. I'm arranging these two based on their importance. The most important smudge tool, number one, the pen tool. These two are the main tools we are going to be needing for this smudge painting. Then the next tool is the dodge tool. We have the dodge tool. See it here, the dodge tool. You can see the dodge tool. This one, they are close together. This dodge, you are seeing it. Then the another one is the eraser brush. You can see this eraser tool. Eraser tool, we are going to be needing it. Then the next one is the brush tool. We're going to be using brush tool. This one is eyedropper. You can see this eyedropper too. We're going to be using eyedropper too. And another one is the I think we don't have. Okay, so the dodge too and the bone tool is sometimes necessary, but not that necessary. Okay, so that's the tool we are going to be using for this for this smudge painting. So but first of all, before you start smudging, you have to remove the image background. You have to crop the background. So first of all, we are going to be learning how to crop using the pen tool. No, this pen tool is used for cropping. The pen tool is used for cropping. The shortcut is P. Want to go to pen tool, just press P on your keyboard, or you go and locate your pen tool here. So the pen tool is used for cropping the image. What do I mean by cropping? Cropping means to trace this image, trace the image from any point, just trace the image and remove it from the background, so we can add another background to the image. That's what cropping is. Just to trace this image and remove it from the background. So remove the background of a particular image. That's what cropping means. So we are going to be using this tool for cropping. So you have to pay very attention, because I'm going to teach you guys how to use this pen tool. This pen tool is a perfect tool for doing this cropping. We have other tools we can use for cropping, like you can use this magnetic lasso tool. You can use lasso tool, polygonal lasso tool, and magnetic for cropping. You can use quick selection tool for cropping. You can equally use magic wand tool to erase the background if the background have a particular color. If the background have a plain background, if you have a plain background, you can use this one. But the main perfect tool for this cropping is the pen tool. It's going to give you perfect line. So now we are going to use the pen tool. We are going to use the pen tool to crop out this image from this background. So picking your pen tool, you start from a point from the image. But before you start cropping, there's one thing you must do. Okay, you have to make sure that the image resolution is 300. You have to make sure the image is okay. Let me not go this side for now. It's going to be on the next part. Okay, before you do that one, you have to remove the background first. Okay, let's remove the background now. So start from any point. Make sure you don't zoom the image so you can trace it very well. Start from any point of your choice. I want to start, say, just pick a point, just click on it, and you click and drag. If you want to make a curve, click and hold, then you drag. Then you can see we have 2 points here. We have this anchor point that protrudes here, and we have another one that protrudes here. After the curve, you have to hold your alt key and click back on this center anchor point. Holding your alt key, you click back on the center anchor point, click on it, the line will return. Then you continue cropping. If you made a mistake, you can undo. The shortcut for undo is Ctrl Z. Just press Ctrl Z, it will undo. So you have to, once you made a curve, you have to hold your alt key, then click back on this anchor point, then you continue. So we are going to trace this image around. So we are cropping this image now from the background. We want to remove the background, so I'm not going to fast forward this. This is our first video, we have to learn it gradually. Okay. Once you make a curve, you hold your alt key, click back on this anchor point to return it before you continue. You must not crop all the hair, because you cannot crop this hair like this. You have to make it there, but not all the parts. You're not going to get it if you want to crop all the hair. I'm going to make a video on how to get it like that, but not this CSS. I'm going to be using CSS version 220. Alright, as you can see now, I have traced it, but I have not selected it. After the tracing, you can see before I join this my pen tool. Once, if you want to join, if you trace your pen tool, you can see something like Zelo have appeared on the bottom of that pen tool before you click it. I seen it now, so we have traced it. So the next thing you're going to, after the tracing, you have to press Ctrl Enter to make a selection. Press Ctrl Enter to make a selection. So you press Ctrl Enter to make a selection. You can see something like a moving line. So it shows that you have made a selection. So after you have made a selection, you have to press Ctrl G. But look at our layer, there's one padlock there. You have to double click on it and press OK. So you have to unlock your layer. Then after the Ctrl Enter, you press Ctrl G to bring that image you trace on a separate layer. I see this here on our layer. You can close this down layer, close your main layer. You can see this eye, just click on it to blind it. So this is our cropped image. I see it now. So we have automatically removed the background, and this is a perfect cropping. So this is what cropping is all about. We have traced the image and we have removed the background. So that's what cropping means. So The next thing we are going to do now is to prepare this image. We are going to prepare this image ready. We are going to get this ready for smudging. Okay?